technology, I heard a lot about this, where this money is coming from for Islamic finance. The answer is, okay, you enjoy the chips, don't worry about the package. And the other thing is that when you said the party, other party should be, should take a risk, but in this case of guidance financing, they're not taking any risk at all. Insurance is the other party's responsibility. If it becomes a defaulter, it's going to be repossessed anyways, just like the other bank. And also, when you are going through the application process, it's exactly the same process, and the person is usually ending up paying any probably 1 or 1.5 point extra. And because these administrative fees, and sometimes like the practices are so abusive, like somebody wants to, let's say, want to change the escrow account. There are higher fees. If you compare it with other, like conventional mortgages.
Let's differentiate between, according to your statement, abusing the Muslim class and taking advantage of them because they want to be practicing Muslim and they want to stay away from riba, versus committing a haram transaction. Are they abusing, you know, people and taking advantage of them up to a certain limit? Unfortunately, yes. Is the partnership a nominal one and it's not a real one? Yes, it is. I agree with you. I'm not saying that Guidance Residential is executing and conducting a pure, halal, legitimate, authentic, sound Islamic finance. They are not. Now, I forgot the third point. But anyway, I already answered the question. When it comes to the risk, have you read their contract? There is one scenario called terminating the partnership based on eminent domain. Eminent domain, they call it? Eminent domain. Like when the house is taken by force by the authority. For example, they want to demolish the house. Eminent domain. Thank you. Making a road or a street or whatever. In this particular case, yes, they share the loss with their client. But if you as a client, if you decide to terminate the partnership with them by law or by the agreement, you have to pay them off whatever they have paid for you. Only and only in case of eminent domain, they share the loss with you. This actually makes, this actually increases the permissibility maybe a little bit.